Welcome to the Elon Phoenix Weekly. I'm Tori Baptist.
And I'm Stephen Normington. Elon Phoenix Weekly is here to shine a light on all the exciting moments in Elon athletics, both on and off the field, beginning with one of the most exhilarating changes in Phoenix sports history.
This fall, teams and coaches enter their first season of competition in the Colonial Athletic Association. They'll face tougher opponents from all over the East Coast.
Some teams, football and men's soccer, add new coaches to the mix. Others, like women's soccer and volleyball, are navigating their challenging schedules with finesse and strength.
All that and more next on the Elon Phoenix Weekly.
Hello, and welcome back to the Elon Phoenix Weekly.
In North Carolina, fall means football, and Elon is no exception. The Phoenix coaching staff might be brand new, but the excitement of game day hasn't changed.
The Elon Phoenix entered the 2014 football season with many changes. The team is competing as a member of the Colonial Athletic Association this season and kicked off a new era of Phoenix football under first-year head coach Rich Grosky.
It's great. I think everybody knows how excited I am to be here at Elon and be the head coach, and being the first game in a great environment over at Duke was a good experience.
The first game of any season is always filled with excitement, and Elon was itching to take the field.
It's finally here. You know, you've been hitting the same people for a whole year at that point. Since the end of the last season, you've only hit your own teammates, so it's cool just to go against somebody else. And there's nothing like game day. There's nothing like, that's what you play for. It's, to win on game days, that's why you play. So it's definitely what you're looking for.
After a strenuous road to recovery, senior linebacker Miles Williams walked onto the field at Duke for his first game in over 2 years.
Great feeling. It's kind of different for me individually because I sat out last season with hip surgery. So coming back was a great experience. I was excited being a captain with Quinn, Sal, and Adele. It was big for me because I didn't know when I'd get back on the field again, and so to be able to have that opportunity in front of that large crowd was pretty exciting.
Elon went into Duke as heavy underdogs, but did not use that as an excuse, and losing to the Blue Devils 48-13 did not sit well with the Phoenix.
That's not acceptable to lose like that. That's one, point one. We don't want to lose. With no exceptions. We have the ability to be a good football team. We will be a good football team. Let's fix this. Let's go on.
Elon would return to Rhodes Stadium for the first time this season, and for the seniors, their last home opener.
Oh man, it was awesome. There's nothing better than playing in Rhodes Stadium for me. I love playing in front of my family, in front of my friends. So going down the Phoenix Walk and seeing everybody then, and then going back on the field and being a part of the team again felt great. So I'm really excited to be back at home.
Being my fifth year, I've been here for a while. For the last time, so it was a little emotional, but it's always good to be home.
It was a game filled with opportunities, but overshadowed by missed chances. Elon fell just short to North Carolina A&T 17-12, a loss that stung.
It definitely hurt. A lot of guys were disappointed because that was a game that we felt like we should have won. We definitely put ourselves in a position to win that football game, and that's one of the things we just had to let it go after 24 hours.
The Phoenix welcome undefeated Charlotte for Game 3 with one of the largest crowds in Rhodes Stadium history.
Home attendance has been great. The students have been awesome. I've done a couple more things on campus. So, I think we're playing an exciting brand of football. I think the kids are giving great energy. And I do think, and the message out to the student body is that energy level helps our team.
Since taking over as head coach, Skrosky has encouraged his players to interact with the rest of the student body and propose a challenge for his freshmen.
Coach Skrosky during the summer made a big deal about how go out, be sociable on campus. He challenged a lot of the freshmen, make 5 friends, 10 friends, and get them to the games, because when you multiply it all, you can get easily 1,000 kids of your friends that are football players, getting their friends out in the game.
It came down to the last play in the last second to decide the game, but Elon came through for its first win of the season, 20-13.
I think one of the things that we realized is that if we execute at a high level or do what we're supposed to do, do our jobs, we can play with pretty much anybody in the country.
Go Elon!
The Phoenix have played a tough non-conference schedule to open the season, which Coach Grosky hopes will help his team later in the season.
And as competitive a schedule, I think at our level as possible, we got to make sure we keep it all in perspective. We got to make sure that we're being as critical, and that's everybody, the coaching staff and the players, as critical of our performance after a win as well as after a loss, because that's the only way you can continue to improve.
Elon senior linebacker Odell Benton earned the school's first ever CAA Football Player of the Week award for his performance against Charlotte. Coach Grosky knows conference play will be upon them soon.
It doesn't get any easier going into CAA. And again, this is going to be a marathon now. It's not a sprint. So we got to take it a day at a time, a week at a time, a game at a time. But I'm looking, I'm excited going into the new conference.
The Phoenix will welcome New Hampshire to Rhodes Stadium for their first ever CAA game.
Coming off the most successful season in program history, men's soccer team returns to the pitch with unprecedented expectations. Chris Little, the team's former assistant coach, is back as head honcho and hopes to maintain the program's prominence and add his own unique flair.
Chuck! Well done, Chuck! Come on, keep going! Good stuff!
The first emotion was just one being very proud for them, I think I know the amount of hard work that these players put in and the commitment levels that they have. And so for that to pay off and them to win a third championship in a row and continue kind of national recognition, national success that they received, having an RPI again in the top 30 in the country, getting to the second round of the national tournament. So to continue to build and take the program forward is fantastic. And that's not an easy task. When you win championships, you kind of have a target on your back and you get everybody's best game. So for them to go and win a third championship, I think was a tremendous achievement for the players and one we're extremely proud of.
We feel really good about leaving the SoCon with our third straight championship ring. That's something that we'll always take with us. And overall, being ranked in the top 25, being able to beat some opponents who are in the top 25 who are considered some powerhouse schools. That was quite an honor for us to do. Being able to play in a home game in the NCAA tournament was something that was really special to us because we'd been in the NCAA tournament before, but this was Elon's first ever NCAA home game that they had in any sport. So that was really cool for us to give the fans here that opportunity. So to play in front of 3,500 fans in that first home game against Clemson was so cool to us, and we're just so happy we were able to give all the Elon Phoenix fans that experience, and being able to win that in PKs in the fashion that we did and have everyone rush the field, and that's an experience that we'll remember, but we hope that the fans will always remember too.
The support that we've received is from the student body and the community has been phenomenal in the last several years. I think we've had three or four games now where we've been over 3,000 spectators at a match, which is extremely exciting. I know the players really benefit from that support. We love playing at home. I think playing at Rudd Field is very unique. The spectators and our fans are so close to the field, they align the fence, and it really creates a unique atmosphere and environment. And
out of my 3 years here, it was certainly the best. There's no doubt about that. Every year it seems to get better for me, it seems to be more exciting, we seem to play better and we seem to be more competitive. Last year was certainly a real roller coaster towards the end. It was such an exciting experience and so exciting to be able to get the whole Elon community involved, and we got so much support from this whole school. So towards the end, especially that NCAA game at home against Clemson, was just a fantastic experience and something that I think we'll all never forget. But I think moving forward, as we've seen every year, our goals have always been to slightly improve every year and to push forward a little bit. So I think next year we have to be looking at continuing to do that, continuing to do well in our conference play. It's going to be an exciting change for us. And then hopefully moving on in the NCAAs and continuing to progress in that field.
I mean, we have very clear goals and standards that we have for the program. The players set our goals each year, but they don't really waver. The expectations on them are always quite similar, and it starts with their character and their hard work. And when we get those things right, which we have in the last several years, you know, their talent then is allowed to blossom and express themselves, and hopefully we can continue the success that we've had.
Well, our past success last year and even the years before have really set up new expectations for this upcoming season. We aren't really satisfied being a team that wins in the first round of the NCAA tournament and goes out. We train and work at everything we do in order to be the best of the best. So we go into every game thinking we can beat this team regardless of who we're playing. And that's something that's really been built upon in these past few years. And so for 2014, this is a season where we're going everywhere thinking that we're going to win this game. We think we're going to win championships. There's no game or opponent that we're scared of.
Please support the men's team during their next few home games as Nathan Dean looks to pass Colorado Rapids goalkeeper Clint Irwin as Elon's leader in career shutouts.
And that brings us to today's trivia. Has Elon's football team ever had an undefeated season? The answer coming up later in the show.
It's time for our first commercial break, but let's take a glimpse at some upcoming games. Coming up, Elon athletes and coaches discuss the program's historic move to the Colonial Athletic Association. Don't go anywhere.
Through their daily pursuit of excellence, Elon student athletes have gained recognition for their achievements, both on and off the field.
Building a winning tradition takes hard work and dedication.
Dedication to the maroon life.
Where success is not only measured by just wins and trophies,
but also by the knowledge we gain.
At Elon, we're more than just athletes.
Student athletes.
Providing support enables success, helps sustain the winning tradition of Elon Athletics while securing the future of our student athletes for years to come.
An Elon education is about preparing students for a life of global citizenship. Of course, this is a place where you're going to come and earn a degree, but it's also a place that's going to get you to think very deeply about how you're going to use that degree to make the world a better place.
What is living the maroon life? It's more than just the hustle and the sweat. It's more than just the pain and the frustration. It's more than just the triumph and the glory. The maroon life is you. Yes, you. You, the athlete, striving to be at your best day in and day out. You, the alumni who have been in the stands supporting Elon for years. You, the fans who stream into games hours before kickoff. And you, the little ones who will be the next generation of Phoenix fans. You are what drives Elon Athletics, and you are the reason we do what we do. There is so much history and tradition behind our maroon. Conference titles, All-American, and national championships. But there is so much history and tradition yet to be made. So join us. Live the maroon life.
Okay.
There are currently over 350 Elon student-athletes competing in 16 NCAA Division I sports.
Scholarships enable us to succeed not only on the field,
but also in the classroom.
It helps us in achieving our commitment.
To live the maroon life.
Your gifts have the power to take Phoenix athletics to even greater heights while giving student athletes an outstanding education.
The Elon Phoenix Weekly is made possible by the students of the School of Communications in association with dedicated coaches, athletes, and staff of Elon Athletics.
Now the answer to today's trivia. Before the break, we asked if Elon's football team has ever had an undefeated season. The answer? Yes. In the fall of 1957, Elon went undefeated and untied in football play, but they did not win the league championship. Two games were canceled because of an influenza outbreak, leaving Elon with enough games to qualify for the title.
Each season provides new challenges for teams to overcome. But with former All-American and professional volleyball player Mary Tendler entering her 12th season as the Elon head coach, the volleyball team is more ready than ever to spike down every obstacle.
With every new season, there's a fresh start. Players leaving, players coming in, and returning players trying to improve on the successes from last season. With Elon Women's Volleyball, that couldn't be more true.
We honestly should be really successful. I'm really excited for the team. We're kind of a young team, but we're also having a lot of returners. But I think that adds intensity to the team and just energy and excitement to play on the court. And going into the CAA adds a lot more excitement to the team because we're ready to go after everyone and everything.
Much of last season's success fell upon graduated seniors Callie Estes and Maggie Richard. But now with those two gone, that level of production will fall on the returning players.
Well, Callie was a very unique player. She set and she hit for us. So it is hard to replace her, but we definitely have the players that are stepping up. One of the strengths of our team is our depth, and we have a couple good setters in Anna and Sadell. And then we have a new right side player in Sydney Busa, who's doing really well.
Losing Maggie also hurt us a lot too, because she was one of our libero. So we missed her in the back row, and also Callie was a big hit on the right side. So we've just all been just working hard as just all becoming good hitters and not just depending on one player. So I think that works with our team is not just having one power hitter, but spreading the wealth.
The start to this new season will be entirely different and special, however. As Elon Athletics makes its transition into the Colonial Athletic Association, the volleyball team is preparing for all the new challenges associated with playing with a whole new batch of teams.
We're excited to go into the CAA and play some new teams. We don't know exactly what we're getting into, but we're going to find out real quickly. As far as pressure, I think anytime you start conference play, there's more pressure than the non-conference. So we're just going to take it one match at a time and do the best we can on our first home weekend.
Like, we want to make a good appearance into the CAA, and going from the SoCon to the CAA, it's a lot more traveling, and we really don't know a lot of the teams from the SoCon. SoCon, we knew a lot of the teams from the back of our hand. The CAA, we only played really three teams in that conference, so we're excited but also really nervous.
With new and challenging teams to play this season, players across the board will have to step up to the occasion.
And we always talk about our season starting in January, and they've been working really, really hard, so even though they're a lot of the same players, they're better than they were last year.
A team surrounded by change going into the season, it'll be up to the senior leadership of players like the Smith sisters to guide the team through all of the season's challenges.
For me, I've always kind of been one of the more vocal players on the team, so I've just kind of been putting a lot more pressure on my teammates to put more pressure on each other. So I think that could really help us just pushing each other to play the best that we can play.
It's fun because I was a captain last year, so it's kind of like the same leadership going on. But I know, like in my meetings, like Coach said, we need a lot more aggressive criticism to our teammates this season. So that's kind of what I'm trying to do. And just we have really had nothing to lose. Like, we're going in, starting brand new, so we're already ranked ninth. So we're kind of starting from the bottom. So just kind of being aggressive and putting a lot more pressure on our teammates and holding ourselves accountable on and off the court.
Phoenix returned a strong core group of players that hope to make an immediate impact in the CAA.
It is still early in the fall season, but the women's soccer team is already out to a strong start.
Elon Athletics has recently made the transition over to the Colonial Athletic Association. This includes the women's soccer team, who had a great last year in the Southern Conference, but is looking to make a name for themselves amongst the new competition.
I think the Colonial brings a different style of play, very challenging schedule.
Going to the CAA, it's going to be a challenge for us, but we're ready for it, and we've been preparing, and you know, we compete.
We're excited to take on that. That's what you want, is an opportunity to compete at the highest level, and the Colonial provides that.
The CAA is, you know, it's a higher level of competition for us. Our team thrives in those high-pressure, high-level situations.
The new season comes with new hurdles, and each year, the teams will look different. However, the team already has a plan in place to conquer this new hurdle.
I think the key word for the freshmen coming in and the returners, regardless of whether or not they played significant minutes or whether or not they're a new freshman, the key word is opportunity.
And we've definitely gotten stronger as a team, and that's going to translate on the field.
A new conference can seem intimidating. While most teams may take a year off to grasp everything new, Coach Neal and this team have their eye on the highest prize, no matter what the new competition has to say.
When it comes to conference, the goal is simple, to win the conference, the regular season and the tournament.
We didn't get that championship, and that's ultimately our goal as a team.
We want to get better every year. A commitment to make sure we evaluate and improve areas of weakness and promote our strengths.
The season is very young to this point, but already the Phoenix has reached some success, with head coach Chris Neal receiving his 100th win of his career with a 2-0 win over Gardner-Webb. The Phoenix will be looking to stockpile on their success as they move forward this season.
The team knows what they want and are ready to go after it this season.
And that brings us to today's history.
On this day in Elon sports history, we take a look back at the Elon men's golf program and the team's 1982 NAIA National Championship. The Elon men's golf team was often overshadowed by the wildly successful football program in the early 1980s, but there is no debating that the Fighting Christians golfers earned their stripes on the links. Led by coach Bill Morningstar and All-American Keith Decker, and bolstered by a plethora of young stars, including the sibling pair of Jimmy and Bill Merriman, the team would go on to win the 1982 National Championship and solidify their place in Elon's sporting lore. That's today's look into Elon sports history.
It's time for our final commercial break before our exclusive CAA preview. Stay tuned.
There are currently over 350 Elon student athletes competing in 16 NCAA Division I sports.
Scholarships enable us to succeed not only on the field,
but also in the classroom.
It helps us in achieving our commitment.
To live the maroon life.
Your gifts have the power to take Phoenix athletics to even greater heights while giving student athletes an outstanding education.
Thank you.
Through their daily pursuit of excellence, Elon student athletes have gained recognition for their achievements, both on and off the field.
Building a winning tradition takes hard work and dedication.
Dedication to the maroon life.
Where success is not only measured by just wins and trophies,
but also by the knowledge we gain.
At Elon, we're more than just athletes.
We're student athletes.
Providing support enables success. Help sustain the winning tradition of Elon Athletics while securing the future of our student athletes for years to come.
Welcome back to the Elon Phoenix Weekly on your ESPN2 local sports break. This is Elon's inaugural year as an official member of the Colonial Athletic Association, and with the move comes new opportunities as well as new challenges.
The 2014-2015 school year marks a new chapter for Elon Athletics. As of July 1, 2014, the university officially became a member of the Colonial Athletic Association.
It's exciting that we're moving to the CAA, and for the conference meet, we definitely want to go out there and make our mark and do as well as we can.
With the move to the CAA especially, I feel like I've always here had an opportunity to play against one of the best conferences in the league. A lot of the student body here is from the Northeast. Moving to the CAA gives us an opportunity to play against schools that they're familiar with. A lot of their families are from up north, so I feel like we'll have a much bigger Elon presence at the games.
It should excite you. It definitely excites me just to know that I'll be going against the best that there is to offer at this level of football. Outside of that, you just see the opportunity that your team can have by playing in this league. And, you know, knowing if you beat these teams, then you'll have definitely a better shot to be recognized as, you know, to gain national recognition. So
I think the CAA is going to be very challenging for us, from the top team to the bottom team. Each match is going to be a battle, but we're going to be ready for it. I'm excited just to see some new venues and to see some new cities. So that's going to be really exciting for us. And I think the players are excited for it as well.
Going into the CIA, you know, also a lot of quality teams there. We certainly know that. And then maybe more so teams in terms of reputation-wise. So we know that games against those are going to be worth more for us moving forward. So we're really excited about that. We're excited to travel up north and to play some of those games. But it's a completely new experience for us in a lot of ways. Some of those teams stylistically will be very different from what we're used to. So we're really interested to see how it's going to go. It's an exciting time, and you know, no game in college soccer is going to be easy, but we know that we can compete in that league.
It's an opportunity we're really excited about. The Colonial will be a great move for us from a soccer's perspective. It's a very tough conference, some great coaches in that league.
This is going to be the best FCS conference, certainly east of the Mississippi and maybe in the country, arguably. I mean, it's going to be a fight every week. But it's a fight and competitive level that we're anxious to, you know, be a part of, and we're anxious to get going in that conference.
Elon will look to no doubt establish their rightful place in the CAA for years to come.
Well, I'm certainly excited. Reaching that footprint, getting in touch with alumni, as well as the heightened competition of CAA is certainly going to be exciting.
Very exciting. If you missed anything or want to watch it again, be sure to check us out on YouTube at youtube.com/ElonPhoenixWeekly.
You can also check us out on Time Warner Cable, channel 1083, to watch us on demand.
Also, be sure to visit ElonPhoenix.com. You'll never miss another touchdown, home run, point, or goal. Be sure to tune in next week when we get inside the heads of Elon's football stars.
On behalf of our producers and crew here at the show, we hope you continue to have a spectacular weekend.
For the Elon Phoenix Weekly, I'm Tori Baptist.
And I'm Stephen Normington. Live the maroon life.